Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Welcome to the November edition of CatsTV. I'm Gunnar Mullins.
And I'm Claire Foreman. We're ready to pump you up for all of November's activities, so get your planners out now for November's news. Band will kick off the month with their Lights Out show tonight at the football field. Don't miss it.
Our last football prep rally was held in October, and this time the 8th grade won. I'm already ready for our first basketball prep rally, so make sure we keep it. That will be November 8th.
The 7th grade regular figure out a better chant this time. We're coming for you.
And now it's time for Fun the Fun Bird, your monthly tales from the office.
This is Fun with Funberg, and I have a secret to tell y'all. We have a new school nurse. See, nurse's office. It's two doors down from my office. So now, if you're sick or you have a boo-boo or you just want your temperature taken, you can come and see her. So we're gonna sneak up on her. This is Nurse Carter, our new school nurse. She's all ready for you. She's got disinfectant wipes. She's got Lysol, gloves, mask. She's got Band-Aids. So anything you need, this school nurse is going to be happy to help you. Out with Fun with Funberg.
Y'all ready for this? On November 5th, our whole school will be attending the battlefield of Honey Springs. This is an awesome piece of history right here in our hometown.
Remember, no Confederate flag stuff, no knives or weapons, but bring money for the food trucks.
Woohoo, for our field trip. We haven't had one since COVID started.
One of my favorite CMS events is coming up to the end of November, and that is our canned food drive. The week of November 15 and 19, this canned food drive supports a local food bank and helps families in need right here in Shakota.
I love helping other people during a month where we're supposed to be thankful. It's also a lot of fun. The class that brings the most canned food items gets a pizza party.
And it's always great to hear the songs Mrs. Roberts and Mrs. Stidham come up with to remind us what was last year.
Green beans to the tune of Jolene.
That was it. So everyone get excited to compete with your third hour class and let's bring the most money in cans in the history of ever, November 15th through 19th.
With more canned food drive info, here's Allie Page with our Student Council President and Vice President, Allie.
I like to move it, move it, woo. I like to move it, move it, woo. I like to move it, move it, woo.
I'm Allie Page with Cats TV. What are you expecting from the canned food drive this year?
We're expecting to get a whole bunch of more cans this year.
What are you going to do with the cans from the students?
We're going to donate them to the Methodist Church for their missions.
And what kinds of canned food do you want the students to get?
Like corn, green beans, and maybe ramen? Yes.
Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Allie. Don't forget, we won't have school for a whole week for Thanksgiving break. I'm ready for some turkey.
Me too. November is also the start of basketball season. Sixth grade teams start off with a tournament in Warner the first week of the month.
The middle school teams have games on the 8th and 11th. Here is Madeline McCutcheon with some of our basketball players. Madeline?
Hey, I'm Evan from CatsTV. I'm here with the 8th grade basketball boys, Weston, Cooper, AJ, and Hudson. And so how are y'all feeling about your first game? Are y'all excited?
We're going to win it again. We're going to win.
How's practice going? Is it fun?
Yeah,
it's going good. Yeah. How do y'all love your coach? Do you like him?
Yeah, pretty good.
So that's it. Make sure to come watch them with the first game.
November 8th.
Make sure to come watch November 8th. And go Cats! Back to you at the desk. Woo!
Also, don't forget to fall back on Sunday, November 7th for Daylight Savings Time. Another group at CMS that has a busy month is the Class of Shakota. After a super successful marching season where they won practically everything, They have Eastern District auditions on November 6th, Winter Miss Pageant fundraiser on the 20th, and Winter Guard tryouts on the 13th.
Here is Chloe Turney with Miss Hackler and more info.
I'm here with Miss Hackler for CatsTV News, asking her some questions for the Shakota Winter Guard. So, what days and times are tryouts and the meetings?
So if you are interested in getting some information on Winter Guard, our meeting is November 3rd. If you're 6th grade through 8th grade, it's going to be during WIN in the band room. And then if you are high school or 5th grade, it's going to be after school starting at 4 p.m.
Well, what teams are there going to be?
So we have three teams that they can make. We have our novice team, which is like our beginning team, and their theme is going to be It's Raining Men. And then our B team is going to be some Diamond Thieves, and they're going to have some cool uniforms. And then our A team is going to be, we're doing Castle by Halsey, and they're going to be Queens.
That sounds really fun. Will it be hard for someone that has never picked up a flag before in their life?
It'll be hard, but it won't be unmanageable. We teach you everything that you need to know, and everyone was a beginner at one time. So we have three separate teams. Basically, our Winter Guard tryouts are basically classification days. If you show that you have your AR points and have good grades, like you're not on the failing list, and that you aren't in trouble for class, then you'll make Winter Guard. You'll just be classified on a specific team.
That'll be all. Back to you at the desk.
Last but not least, one of the most important days in November is Veterans Day. We will be watching the parade and having an assembly on the 11th.
Remember, it is a serious event, so even if you can't hear very well, we are supposed to stand quietly and be respectful of all the veterans in the crowd.
Last thing for us here at the news desk is to get ready for the Shakota Christmas Parade on December 1st.
And remember to keep reading for our second AR deadline before Christmas break.
That's all for us here at the desk. Here's a recap of everything you need to know for November.
The November vocabulary word of the month is adversity, an adverse or unfortunate event or circumstance. You will meet many adversities in life. The slang word of the month is simp, someone who shows excessive attention toward another person who does not reciprocate the same feelings. He is such a simp, he sent her flowers 3 times this week. The staff highlight for November is our secretary, Mrs. Thunberg. Ms. Funberg went to college at Connor State College. She says kids should go there because we're a small town school and the kids get more attention there. What does she like best about being the secretary? Getting to know the students. If she wasn't a secretary, what she would do is be a full-time dog sitter.
This has been your November news. Happy Thanksgiving and go Cats!